Okay. In this case, Linda and Sharifah started driving from A to B. Okay, again for speed questions, it's very important to draw a proper and neat speed, sorry, distance timeline. So from A to B, then we have L for Linda and S for Sharifah. Okay, so Sharifah, and because both of them are driving from A to B, these two arrows point towards B to tell us that they are driving towards B. So Sharifah reached town B in 2 hours and 45 minutes. So I put a S1 to indicate the next position after S. Okay, and L1 also means that at 2 hours and 45 minutes, it has reached 7/8 of the journey here, and is slower by 8 km/h. Okay, so you see that drawing a distance timeline is in fact same as drawing a model. You got to be complete and concise. So now, can you see that everything is transferred from here to here, and there's no need for me to go back again? So now, okay, let's see. Again, for speed question, you'll need to draw this triangle here on the left side to help you. This D stands for distance, S for speed, and T for time. Yeah, so gotta follow me. See, in this case, hour and minutes, we need to change to hour because, as you know, all calculations for speed, distance, and time is in hours. So we gotta change to 2 3/4 hour to 11/4 hours. So the thing here is you gotta make sure that your child is able to do this. Some children who is weak in fractions, or they cannot see that 45 minutes is actually at a 3/4 phase of the clock. So this is also one part that child must make sure that they are able to do it quickly. And then, okay, this part is a bit interesting. Since Linda is 8 km/h slower, that means after this amount of time has passed, after 2 hours and 45 minutes has passed, how far behind is Linda? So Linda is 11/4 the time times the difference in the speed, which is times 8, which is 22 km/h. So in this case, Linda has fallen back behind Sharifah by 22 km/h. Okay, yeah. So now with this is everything is simple because we know that one unit is 22 km/h. Okay, so what is Linda's speed? We know that to find Linda's speed, it should be distance over time. So distance from here to here is 7 units because of this part. So 7 units times 22 equals to 154. We have the distance divided by the time, which is the same. And this is KCF, keep, change, flip, keep, divide, mean keep the number, change, divide 2 times, flip this one, okay? So make sure that your child knows how to divide fraction. And we get 56 km/h. Now, this is part A. So for B, find the distance between town A and B. Okay, again, straightforward. Since one unit is 22, total is 8 units. So 22 times 8, which is 176 km/h. So make sure that your units is correct because, again, this is a 2 and 2 marks question, I suppose. Okay, it's missing. Not writing down the correct units will end up in deduction of half a mark. Yeah, so don't let it go to waste lah. Okay, so hope this helps. Thanks.